And a good evening, everybody. Jewel here with you. And Eastern North Carolina is under a tropical storm watch. That happened a little earlier this afternoon. I've been going over some things. I'm just going to use the National Hurricane Center stuff as of right now, but you can see that this is known right now as Tropical Depression 1. Now, the maximum sustained winds are 35 miles per hour. The minimum central pressure is 1,008 millibars. It's moving north-northeast at around 13 miles per hour. And if you're tracking, it's located 28.4 north, 78.6 west. Keep all of this in mind. It's going to get much stronger at some point, looking like probably coming up in about 36 hours, the wind will be 45 miles per hour, and in 60 hours, it'll be 60 mile per hour winds. Not hurricane strength, but tropical storm strength indeed, and it will become Arthur at some point. So, let's check some things out. As you can see, it's just the North Carolina coast. Everything in yellow. We are under a tropical storm watch as of now. This thing should push on through sometime Monday. We'll wait and see exactly how strong it is. By tomorrow afternoon at some point, I'll be able to actually give you some things that'll probably make a lot of sense as far as accuracy goes. It's looking like, though, that from all the satellite images and the Doppler radar data and the surface observations, they indicate that this low pressure just off the coast of Florida has developed significant enough organization with a little bit of circulation trying to make it through. See, right now, here it is. It hasn't got that circulation, but probably before tomorrow afternoon, it's going to get a little circulation, as you can see. Now, the low-level center of it's well-defined now, and deep convection has persisted near the center and in the bands on the east side of the circulation for the past several hours. Now, the cyclone is considered tropical instead of subtropical because it has central deep convection and relatively small radius of maximum wind bands. Now, the intensity is estimated to be, like I said, around 35 knots. And this was collected on the Air Force Hurricane Hunter airplane that went out this morning. And another one scheduled to go out and investigate later this evening. So we'll have some more updates for you. Now, based on the satellite data and the earlier reconnaissance fixes, it's looking like the initial motion of the system is north-northeastward at 11 knots, and it's going to continue north-northeastern motion at about the same forward speed during the next 24 hours or so. And this is going to keep the cyclone offshore, but parallel to the east coast of Florida. Now, after that time, the model solutions begin to diverge, and the details of the track forecast become more complicated. The important features for the future track of this system appear to be a pair of mid to upper level troughs. I've been telling you, we're going to have a cold front come in. Well, there's a low right over in this area, and it's going to like elongate. There's going to be some troughs that make up. All of this stuff is coming true. Now, currently over the central U.S. is where these upper-level troughs are going to be, as they are right now. They're over the central U.S., and the specific amplitude and timing and location of these troughs will ultimately result in how close to the coast of North Carolina this system gets. Now, the GFS and the HWRF models are on the left side of the guidance here, and they bring the system more inland, like I showed you this morning, along the coast, while the European and the UK Met models show an offshore track. Now, what the National Hurricane Center has done with this track, it's split the difference of these solutions And this is where it's looking like it's going to go. You hear me talk about there's math included in this and you have to do a lot of figuring with it. This is what it's looking like right now. And we're going to go by the National Hurricane System. Now, it's going to gradually strengthen during the next couple of days. And during these next couple of days, it remains over the Gulf Stream current. If you remember, the other day, I showed you where that warm little place of air was right off the coast. That's where it's at. That's the Gulf of Mexico warm stream that's going on. I don't know what just happened then, but you saw it the other day as I showed it to you. This is exactly where it looks like it could be. Now, it could come inland here. It could come inland here. It's going to cause tremendous rip current and surf problems, okay? A whole lot of them. And, once again, in 36 hours, it's going to have 45 mile per hour winds. The winds are going to increase steadily over time. And probably 60 hours out from now, 60 mile per hour winds. Here's the key messages for Tropical Depression 1, which I really know is going to become Arthur before it's over. 1, Tropical Storm Watch has been issued for a portion of the North Carolina coast, as I just showed you. Tropical storm force winds and heavy rains are possible in North Carolina in the yellow area I showed you, as you see here, for Monday. Dangerous coastal surf conditions. Rip currents are expected to spread northward from Florida to the mid-Atlantic states during the next few days. It's already started. It's very low up in here, gets to moderate, and then gets to high. Right now, as of today, if you're at the beach or you're going to the beach and you're going out in the water, please make sure there's a lifeguard there. Tropical storm watch, here we go. Winds side of the south, 25 to 35 knots with gusts of 55 knots and seas 4 to 9 feet. Remember, all along I've been talking about if the water starts to pile up. Well, the coastal waters from Ocracoke Inlet, the Surf City. This is where it's going to happen. Tropical storm force winds are possible from early Monday morning until Monday afternoon. Impacts. Very strong winds will cause hazardous seas, which could capsize or damage vessels and reduce visibility. All mariners out there, consider alerting plans to avoid possible hazardous conditions. You need to remain in port, seek a safe harbor, alter your course, and or secure the vessel for severe wind and seas. If you don't listen and pay attention to any other portion of this forecast, please listen to this. This is for what is more than likely going to happen and what you can expect. Here are the current watches and warnings right now. Tropical Storm Watch, once again, in effect for Beaufort County, that's mine, Coastal Onslow, East Carteret, Hatteras Island, Mainland Dare, Mainland Hyde, Northern Outer Banks, Ocracoke Island, Pamlico, Southern, Craven, Tyrrell, Washington, and West Carteret. Right now, the storm's about 510 miles south-southeast or southwest of Buxton, North Carolina, or about 450 miles south-southwest of Morehead City. Storm intensity, as we have seen now, it's 35 miles per hour. The situation overview. This is currently located off the east central Florida coast. It's forecast to strengthen and lift northward near the North Carolina coast Sunday night and Monday. There is still a little of uncertainty regarding the exact forecast track, and a slight shift could change everything. Now, I'm just telling you, you need to watch this very careful. The center of the storm could remain off the North Carolina coast, or it could make landfall. Now, the winds will be possible along the coast, and these winds could lead to some downed trees and widely scattered power outages. Also, we could have some storm surge. It could be minor storm surge impacts. As I said earlier today, they're going to be possible for areas adjacent to the oceans, sounds, and rivers. However, impacts at specific locations will be highly track dependent. Dangerous marine conditions, as I've just told you, the seas are going to build 8 to 10 feet. So far as the wind, you could have some damage to your roofing, siding, along with damage to porches, awnings, carports, sheds, a few buildings experiencing window, door, and garage door failures, mobile home damage, especially if it's unanchored. You need to make sure lightweight objects are secured down if they're unsecured. Several large trees can be uprooted or snapped. That's what happened to me in Florence. It got uprooted. It wasn't the wind, and it wasn't the rain. So, especially where they're shallow rooted, fences and roadway signs can blow over. Some roads impassable from large debris. You see it all right here, folks. So, please, please pay attention. Elsewhere across eastern North Carolina, little to no impact is anticipated. It's just in these counties I told you, and my county's in it, okay? Now, this surge for locally hazardous surge, limited impacts are adjacent to the ocean, sounds, and rivers. Yes, that includes me. Localized inundation and storm surge flooding, mainly along immediate shorelines and in low-lying spots, or in areas further inland near where higher surge waters move ashore. Sections of near-shore roads and parking lots become overspread with surge water. That's possible. Not saying it's going to happen. It could. Driving conditions dangerous in places where surge water covers the road. Moderate beach erosion, heavy surf also breaching the dunes. And minor to locally moderate damage to marinas, docks, boardwalks, and piers, and a few small craft can break away from mooring. Other than that, in other places, nothing. Nothing's going to happen. No flooding rain. The very first video I made on this, do you remember I said, this kind of reminds me of Florence because it's looking like it may try to stall off the coast. But everybody needs to prepare. You know all the do's and the don'ts in here. Don't focus on the exact forecast track. Just do what you're supposed to. Make sure you got a kit. Make sure you got a plan. Make sure you've got your whatever you need up supplies. I try to keep mine all year round. So, and always heed the advice of your local officials and comply with their orders that are issued. And do not needlessly jeopardize your life or the lives of others. Now, I will have more on this. In the meantime, it's coming, folks. So be ready for it. I'll keep you up to date the best I can. Please stay safe, stay cautious, and keep up with this system, this Tropical Depression 1, because I have a feeling it really is going to be Arthur before it's all over. Peace, love, and kindness to each of you.